Hello, smart people. Rose here. Welcome back to Academic Gus, and this is day 11 of Academic Gus, and I'm going to share with you the circumstances under which the vegan police would caught me red-handed. On day 4, I believe, I shared with you the reasons why I am a vegan. And on day 9, if I'm not mistaken, we took a look at my PhD vegan groceries. So today I want to tell you a little bit more about my vegan situations and under which conditions I would not be a vegan. And by this I mean under which circumstances I would actually eat animal products. So first of all, I strongly believe that I am not gonna eat animal flesh unless it's an extraordinary situation. For example, I know that there are many memes around the internet and some people tell you like, oh, but if there's a zombie apocalypse, would you eat meat? And my answer is, of course, if there's nothing else and I have to hunt for my own food, I would eat meat. But I don't believe that I would eat meat as long as the animals are enslaved and are not actually given the chance to be and not treated as property and things. So that would be an extreme situation where there are zombies or where there's been a shutdown or something like that, in which I would have to go into the wild and hunt for my own food. In addition to that, in normal life circumstances, I would actually go vegetarian if there are certain places where I can simply not find something that's 100% vegan. And a place like this would be, for example, my hometown or back home in Puerto Rico. It's not as accessible, the vegan diet. Sure, you can buy all your groceries, you can make all your meals at home, but going out, it's really hard to find a 100% vegan place. And you have to make many adjustments, and there are certain restaurants where there's always something that came in contact with dairy or had an egg or had something of the sort. And in those situations, I would definitely eat that dish, especially if I'm ravishing and I need to eat like now, I would do the exception. But I have to mention, I don't tend to do those exceptions a lot as I am allergic to lactose. I am lactose intolerant. And in addition to that, I don't really like eggs. So it's really rare situations under which I would do that. Another situation that I can imagine myself breaking my vegan vow, let's call it that, would be if I am the invited guest of someone of high importance. Hopefully that happens someday. And I didn't tell my host in advance that I did not eat animal products. In that case, I would just sip it and try to eat in order not to offend them. And the same would happen if I am a guest of another culture or someone from another culture where refusing food would be offensive. In that case, I would definitely break the vegan vow. So those are the circumstances under which I would not be a vegan. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you again tomorrow for day 12. Bye, smart people!